All right, next question here is from BSky05. How do you build confidence in a dog that has anxiety with loud noises such as gunshots, fireworks, and thunderstorms? All right, so this is a good one, given the fact that we have 4th of July coming up here, and it's something that a lot of people will struggle with. So first off, let's make it known that things like this for some dogs are like the hardest thing that you'll ever have to work through with them. And things like this for some dogs that have massive amounts of anxiety towards them is something you're never gonna get perfect, right? Those dogs just genetically are wired to be really skittish around those types of things. So you gotta first and foremost, before you even try to work through these things, understand that and understand how to manage your dog in those situations. If you have a dog that loses it and it just becomes an extreme flight risk and is trying to take off and hide and just becomes uncontrolled, be scared. When you know things like fireworks or thunderstorms, or you're gonna be around where gunshots are, you gotta have your dog contained, right? Keep the dog inside, crate the dog if you need to as you're managing through these things, and don't give the dog an opportunity to take off. I don't understand why people take their dogs out to firework displays. I don't care how good your dog is. It is not a good idea. It is a terrible idea, and you're asking for something bad to happen. You're asking for your dog to run away, right? So understand that first, do this in a totally safe, totally controlled, totally enclosed environment where there's not gonna be a risk of anything, right? Next, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to adopt the 50-50 rule that I talk about all the time, which is taking your dog's brain and getting it to focus 50% on something else, right? So I always say, no matter what is going on in the environment, no matter what it is, right? All of those things are just distractions, right? Now, it is unrealistic for me to say that a distraction of a firework going off 10 feet from them is going to be something that they should be able to work through, because frankly, that's something that most dogs would not be able to work through, right? But if you're in your house and they're going on somewhere else and it's really not anything that's even startling you, right? Then, you know, that's something that's realistically something they would need to focus through, right? It is a safety hazard for my dog to not pay attention and not listen to me while noises are going on, right? So this all starts with your communication, right? Do you have something that your dog knows really, 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 really well, right? Typically in the house, this is the bedstay, right? Do you have a means of enforcing that bedstay, right? And can you make your dog care more about the rewards and the consequences for not doing that than they do about that outside thing? Initially, it's gonna be challenging, but I've worked dogs through this plenty of times before. You pick whatever command it is. You tell your dog, listen, this is what I'm gonna need you to do. And ultimately, I need you to cope with your fears and anxieties in a healthier way than just darting off right now. So I'm gonna ask you to do this command right now. If you don't do it, there's gonna be a big consequence for it so that I can get you to focus, right? If I can get you to focus. Once you get on it, I'll reward you for it, right? If they want the reward, great. If they're too nervous about what's going on, then don't worry about it, right? And what's gonna happen is I'm gonna continue enforcing that and continue having the dog hold that nice and firmly, right? And the first couple times that you do it, your dog is still going to be terrified while it's going on, right? They're still gonna be super anxious. They're gonna be a mess initially, right? But you've achieved the first goal here. And the first goal is not your dog's emotional state of mind of how much they like doing what you're asking them to do. The first goal is, do I have control over my dog still while this is happening? Because that's the important part. That's the safety part of things. Do I have control over my dog in this state? Because I never want to run into a situation, I don't care what's going on, where I don't have control over my dog. Then what'll happen is as the dog gets comfortable in doing that thing, you could start to add in different types of games and different types of rewards and toys and things like that to get your dog a little bit more confident, a little bit more comfortable in doing it. And then each time you ask your dog to do something in this type of environment, whether it's fireworks going off or thunderstorms or whatever it may be, and your dog does it successfully with less needed corrections, you're moving in the correct direction, right? If I needed to correct my dog 5 times at a level 80, right, for not getting on the bed the first time I did this, and then the second time I needed to correct my dog, you know, at a 50, 4 times, and the next time I was able to do it once at a 30, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, I'm moving in the right direction, right? The dog is getting better in that environment because they're less concerned. They're showing me they're less concerned about the thing going on around them by responding with less motivation, less times, right? Then once you can get to the point where they do it consistently every time without the need of a correction or with one simple correction each time, then you know you're really smooth sailing here, right? Then you're gonna start to see over time that state of mind gets better. But like I said, I'm not looking for it to look perfect. A lot of people worry too much about the confidence side of things in those situations as opposed to realizing that's a scary situation for anybody, right? There are certain things that I need to do or I'm asked to do that are hard for me or they're scared of me, right? Or they're scared of those things in that situation. And it's something where if you worry too much about getting them over that, as opposed to do I have the control and is it posing any sort of problem, then you're not gonna make as much progress as you need to. So make the goal first and foremost, do I have control over my dog in this situation? And second, worry about their overall confidence. And you're gonna see that through the ease of getting them into command in those types of situations. So that's how I work through these things. Be safe about it, make your criteria what you want it to be and follow both of those steps, and you're gonna get over that issue pretty quickly with your dog.